Good morning, everyone. I'm coming to you live at 9 here on my business page. Today, we're going to be talking about the top three things that I am doing right now to thrive and not just survive, you know, with everything that's happening in the world. So if you're new to me, my name is Kylie Ulta, and I help women step into the true essence of themselves and just be the leader that they were called to be, right? Right now, more than ever, it is time for us to step as women into our leadership role, right? And so I'm going to be talking more about how I continue to step into my leadership role, even if things aren't going according to plan, things aren't going the way that I, quote, think they should be. So I just wanted to give you some really quick tips that you can apply right now to step into that leadership role that you were meant to be. Okay, so I'm just gonna go backwards, 3, 2, 1. Not necessarily in that order of importance, but I don't know, I just like counting up. So number 3, spending time with God so that I can hear his heart. Again, spending time with God so I can hear his heart. And in the past, I used to kind of just check God time off in a box. Now, especially in this season, there's so much coming at us, so much information, whether it's on the news, whether it's from people you follow online, everybody and their mom has an opinion. I mean, including me, I have an opinion about where God's taking me, where God's leading me, and all of that. And right now, it's such... especially if we are leading others, it's very important to listen to what God is saying in this season, because if we get steered in the wrong direction, then like how many other people are we gonna take off the cliff with us? So it's very important for us to listen and connect to God and hear what he's saying so that we can steer the boat in the right direction, because there's other people on the boat with us. Am I right? So. Things that I do specifically is I read the Bible every morning, and I sit in that chair right there in my office, and I use the point and shoot method. Pretty much I open the Bible and I'm like, well, before I open the Bible, I go, okay, God, what do you want to speak to me today? You know, and then you just tune into the heart of God and he'll speak to you. And what happens for me is I'll open it, and then, I kid you not, whatever pops out on the page is exactly what I needed to hear that day, either for me or for my clients. And so this is also what I do when I hop on the phone with my clients, or even people that I'm just connecting to. My God leads me to connect with them. Is, okay, God, I'm hopping on this call. Do you have a specific word for this person that I'm going to connect with? And then he shows me a word, whether it's for me, whether for somebody else. And then if God leads me to share a word of knowledge with someone, I will share that word. And so that's number 3, just getting really clear and spending time with God, because we have to really silence the noise. Because I mean, the enemy's at work. What can we say? The enemy's at work. We need to silence the noise so that we can hear clearly from God where we're going. And that's also what I'm doing with this page. You know, God has called me to actually teach on leadership and how we as women are called to lead during this time. So here's me being obedient and going more live consistently to share the knowledge that, you know, God's been sharing with me. Okay. So number 2, so, right, we just talked about spending time with God so we can hear his heart. One more thing about that, a lot of people right now are feeling lost. They're not sure what direction they're headed. And that's why it's now more than ever, we should be tuning in to the heart of God, so that we are not confused, we're not distracted. God is really calling us to step into our power and into our leadership. Hi, John. God is just really calling us to step into our calling. And so we need to hear from him clearly. So, yes. Number two, get into your creative side, right? God is our creator. We are created in the image of God. Therefore, we must create. And God gave us all of these different talents and abilities. One of the people that I follow, he calls them gates. I don't know what, I'll post down what gates are, but it's pretty much gifts and talents and shucks. I'll remember it next time. I didn't write it down, but I felt like I needed to share. Anyway, his name is Charlie Gilkey, and he has the website productiveflourishing.com, and I have his planner. It's called the Momentum Planner. I love it. I love it. He really helps you to hone in, one, to really step into your gifting. And so it's not like you have a goal that is misaligned, right? And that's why first, right, we hear from God, and then we tune into our own gifts and talents, and using our gifts and talents is what we put out into the world. And also tapping into that creative side, like, yes, for those of us who work from home, who have businesses, or even those who have been furloughed or laid off, but have a vision of where we want to be in the marketplace, even starting a business. I don't know, but just, I know right now is a pretty good time to start a business, even though it seems like, what? I've been learning more about asset strategies and financial things, and I'm just blown away about what is provided to us as business owners and how we manage our finances and things. It's a game changer. So, right, we need to step into the creative side, one, to get us out of the funk, you know? I don't know about you, but with everything that's happening in the world, sometimes it feels like I'm on an emotional roller coaster. One, I check in, like, have I checked in with God today? Okay, if I have, and then if I'm still not out of the funk, what I do is I try to inject some fun. So, y'all know, I love Disneyland. So, I go into Zoom calls, sometimes with my ears on. Just saying, I go into Zoom calls with my ears on. And it really, you know, it brings joy, it brings laughter to others. Because who doesn't love Disneyland? You know, it's when you can't go, it's mad, you know, you can inject some of that Disney magic into your day. It's always fun for me. I mean, like, I feel like I'm happier now with my ears on. Another thing that I do is I tap into my dancing or my singing. And I love singing. I have my Alexa here, and I can just tell her, you know, Alexa, you know, play something, blah, blah, blah. And she plays it for me, and then I dance and I sing right here in my office. And another thing I do is, like, when I feel like right now is a time for us to be called into worship, right? We're called into a season of worship so that, one, we can be closer to God, but also, like, I don't know about you, but when I get into worship, and I think that's just the very nature of worship, when we get into God, we get into worship with him, it's like we're just like ushered into his presence, and it just feels, it just alleviates any pressure, any stress that I have. And then how I step into that worship is, if you're new to me, right, I am from Hawaii, I am a native Hawaiian, and I've pretty much been dancing hula since the age of 4. My whole family, like our lineage, like my great grandma owned one of the first hula studios in downtown Honolulu, and she was one of the first to teach non-Hawaiians how to dance hula. So she had, you know, haole, or haole is like for white people, but me just means foreigner. So she taught anyone and everyone who wanted to learn, because she wanted to preserve, you know, hula and all of that. And so hula is very part of my nature and who I am. And so, you know, God what, you know, when I hear worship songs, sometimes instead of singing, I just get into dance, and I unlock my creativity by just, you know, I don't know. For me, I feel it in my body, and I just move with the spirit. I do hand motions and whatever, you know, I just make up my own dance, and it feels so freeing. And just stepping into that creative zone just really unlocks and moves me out of any negativity that I may have been stuck in. So like for you, it might be creative dance. It might be even dancing with flags. I don't have flags, but you know, I have scarves. It's cold here, so I have scarves. You know, you can do whatever you want, but you have to tap into that creative zone, because I said, right, God is our creator. When we step into our own creativity, we align with him, and then we create something beautiful. And it just clears the cobwebs away of what the enemy really, if he's trying to, you know, get those arrows into you, it's, for me, it's my way of deflecting the negativity and just really stepping into who God called me to be, and really own that and step into that. Okay. So the last thing I want to talk about, right, we already talked about spending time with God, and number two, stepping into your creative side, and how to just bring more fun into your day. And the last thing I wanted to talk about is learn something new. Learn something new that you've always wanted to do. So right now I'm looking into learning how to play piano, because I have all of these songs that I write poetry and things, but I don't play the guitar or the piano. But I have all of these songs I feel like are locked inside of me. And if the one thing keeping me from writing songs is learning how to play the piano, I mean, hello, YouTube, right? Why don't I just start knocking down the barriers that are keeping me from where God, I know God has called me to be? And so the other thing that I've been doing is, I thought that I'm not a very good writer. You know, I have, so for me, it's like writing creatively versus writing corporate style, you know, very, I don't want to say like legalistic, but very, you know what I mean? Like reading a textbook versus reading a storybook. And so God's releasing me and freeing me from that. And I just signed up for Proverbs 31 Ministries has a writing class, or like a writing, it's called Compel Writing Training or something like that. It's Compel Ministries, and part of it's a subsidiary of Proverbs 31 Ministries, and they, I'm on their email newsletter, and they said right now it's opened up. They only open up like quarterly or like twice a year, but I think for COVID right now they opened the gates. I don't know if it's still open, but because I missed the boat, God's been speaking to me about writing for about 2 years now. And I'm like, well, I'm not a good writer, you know? But when God calls you into something, you really should step into that. Because, right, we all know delayed obedience is just disobedience. I mean, this, it's in real life with our kids, right? If we tell them to, like, hey, go do such and such, and they don't do it, or they do it later, it's still like delayed obedience is still disobedience, because when they don't do it the first time, right, it's like, hello, you're not listening to me, like technically disobeying us, right? And so it's the same thing with God, and I feel like right now a lot is being released into the atmosphere. I mean, I'm a feeler, so I'm feeling all the things that are happening in the atmosphere, and it's overwhelming sometimes. So that's why these three things I do pretty much every day to just step out of confusion, out of overwhelm, and just into the presence of God, and really refocusing and shifting my mind onto what God wants me to do today instead of what the world or the news or what anyone else wants me to do today. Does that make sense? So, I have a call that I gotta step into right after this, but my calling, whatever, they call it CTA, call to action. My call to action for those of you who watch this or watching on the replay is one, what has God already called you to do? What has He already called you to do? Just journal on it, think about it, pray about it. And I know those of you who hop on this and watch this eventually, like now or later, God has already called you into something. So, you know, like, what are you going to do to step into that? And if there are any like barriers that are coming up against you, like for me, it's like, well, I don't play the piano, so I can't write songs. Well, hello, learn how to play the piano, right? And oh, I'm not very good at writing. You know, I've taken a lot of writing classes and speaking. Doing this is not. If you only knew how terrified I am of public speaking, or was, you know, gotta retrain our mouths, right? How terrified I was about public speaking in high school. It's just crazy. Like, I could never get through one of these speeches without crying, without like just really breaking down. And that's why most of my lives are just impromptu, what God puts in my heart. I'm really trying to get focused and do a plan, because God has been stressing to me, like, Kylie, you need a plan. And so just getting on here and doing a live, a planned live with actual bullet points, not my forte. And so I always think, I'm gonna forget what to say. And that used to freak me out when I was in high school. And like, all of the videos were recorded. If you went to Kamehameha schools, you know that we have mandatory speech class, and everything was filmed. You know, I could look into, like, one, like, seeing the people in the classroom was deathly scary for me. And being up front in front of people was scary. But then also, like, not remembering my points of what I was going to say. Scary. So, you know, I'm just saying, you know, as you're stepping into your calling, it's going to feel scary. Anyway, what I wanted to bring up about that point was, I saw someone who, so his name is John Bevere, and he failed like high school English, but God told him specifically to write books. And I just remember sitting in the audience, and I heard God told me, you know, I need you to speak. And I was like, what? He's like, yeah, if John can write books, you can speak on the stage. I said, God, no, not me. Do not call me to be a speaker. Do not call me to be in front of anyone, because you know that that's not my forte. But he knows that, like, talking, I like talking. If you're my friend in real life, you know how much I love talking. But talking about specific points and writing books and then talking about those books on stage, I'm like, God, why? Why? But you know, it's not about us. It's all about honoring God and stepping into that calling, right? We have to honor the path that God has set before us. And if we're scared to step into it, one, write down the barriers, like, that the enemy's bringing to your mind, like right now as you're watching. Oh, I can't because, and then you just write it all out. You know, one of my clients contacted me this morning, and she was like, I don't know if I'm just afraid, like, where it was coming from. I said, you know what, just write a list. So take a piece of paper, right? Take a piece of paper, draw a line down the middle on the left side, right? Write down every lie, like, why you can't. And then on the right side, find, just really say what God has said about you. So, yeah, if you know who I am, I just love giving you practical tips, because yes, mindset and everything, like, that's all good, but you need to take specific action to get you out of the funk. You know, you just need something to get you out of the funk. Do that. Write down what the enemy's saying on one side, write down what God's actually saying to you. And just as you write down and you counteract the lies, just cross them off and then circle. Nope, this is what God says about me. Simple. Okay. So again, what is God calling you to step into? Number one, and then two, debunk the lies. So that as a recap, the top three things I'm doing right now to thrive is one, spending time with God so I can hear his heart. Number two, getting into my creative side because God is our creator. Therefore, we are to be creators ourselves, right? So when I'm dancing, oh, I forgot. We also did a virtual karaoke or karaoke, however, if you want to say it howly, if you want to say it regular, right? We did virtual karaoke and it was so fun. So fun. I was making excuses as to why I haven't found a place to sing, like, you know, no excuses. Hop on Zoom, we did it. It was fine. And then also showing up on my Zoom calls with my ears, my Disney ears. Just, it's, you gotta have some fun in your day. And then the last but not least is learn something. Like, invest if you have to, like, or get on YouTube if you have to. Like, if there's a specific calling God has on your life, don't let your lack of knowledge be the barrier to you moving forward. There's so much information right now. I mean, heck, I give out information too. So, yeah, let that be your call to action today. What is God speaking to you? Any barriers? And just write them down on the left side. The lies of the enemy, why I can't do this. And on the right side, just write down what is God saying and how you're gonna just debunk all the myths that are coming out. Okay, so I gotta hop off. I have another call to hop on into. Let's see. You know, before I leave, why don't we just pray? God, thank you for being here today. Thank you for being here on this live and just directing my steps. And I just thank you for every person that watches this live, either today or on the replay. And I thank you, Lord, for one, instilling the gifts that you have for the people that are watching and just having them like tune into you and listen to you in this time. And God, I just declare that no weapon formed against them shall prosper. Whether they are sick right now, we call in healing. God, whether they are God, we just speak to their finances right now, and that where they are stuck in their finances, that God, you will bring a creative solution for them to receive finances right now, even in the middle of a crisis. And we just thank you, Lord, for your provision. We thank you, Lord, for supernatural debt cancellation. And we speak life and we speak love into everyone who is watching this video. We just give you all the praise and the glory today and every day. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, go. Go be great, and I'll talk to you next week. Bye.